So earlier, when we created a view, I briefly explained what a partial view is. In this video, we're going to take a closer look at partial views. So in Solution Explorer, open up Views, Shared, Layout. This is the Bootstrap template that defines the overall look and feel of our website. So we've got the standard HTML head and body sections. Inside the body, we've got a div that represents our navigation bar. Let's collapse this, hold down Control, and press M twice. Below this nav bar, we have a container for our pages. Note this call to render body method. So what we put in our views will be placed here when the view is rendered. And you can see below that we've got a horizontal line and a footer. Now, I told you that a partial view is like a small view that we can reuse on different views. But partial views are not necessarily for reusing markup. Sometimes, we can use them to break down a large view into smaller, more maintainable partial views. For example, let me expand this navigation bar element again. You can see that we have a fair amount of markup on this view. While this is not terribly bad, we can improve the maintainability of this layout by extracting the part that represents the navigation bar into a partial view. So let's do that. Back in Solution Explorer, right-click Shared, Add, View. By convention, we prefix partial view names with an underscore. So let's call this underscore nav bar. We need to tick this checkbox here, Create as a partial view. This way, this view will not have a layout. Okay, now Control Tab to get back to the layout. Scroll up a little bit. So here's our navbar element again. Put the cursor on this element, hold down the Control and press M twice. Okay, collapsed. Control X to cut. Back to navigation bar. Paste it here. Now we can see in this partial view, we only have the navigation bar, nothing else. So next time we want to change something on our navigation bar, we can simply jump to this partial view. We don't have to scroll up and down in the main layout. Save. Now back to the layout. So here's the content area of our pages. The navigation bar was above that. So here we need to render that partial view. We use @HTML. This is a property of our views, which is of type HTML helper. So it's a class that provides a number of useful methods to work with HTML. We're going to use the partial method. Here we pass the name of our partial view, underline navbar. That's it. That's how we use a partial view on another view. Now, optionally, we can pass a model to this partial view as the second argument of this partial method. Now, in this case, we don't have a model in our layout, but let me temporarily just declare a model for demonstration. So on top of this view, I'm going to add the model directive, and let's set this to random movie view model. Now here, if I don't specify a model, the model that is currently passed to this layout view will be automatically passed to this partial view. But let's say this navbar expects a movie, not the entire random movie view model. Then we can supply a model as a second argument. So model.movie. Okay, we've covered a lot of ground about various components of ASP.NET MVC. So in the next lecture, you will get a cheat sheet to quickly overview the materials in this section. And then I'm going to give you an exercise to put what you have learned in action.